Prime Minister Modi is likely to get a clean chit from the poll panel in a complaint accusing him of violating the election model code of conduct during campaigning in Uttar Pradesh's Pilibhit on April 9th. The complaint referred to Modi's reference to the construction of Ram Mandir, Kartarpur Sahib corridor and the government's action of bringing back copies of the Guru Granth Sahib from Afghanistan. Sources say the Election Commission has stated that the Prime Minister's mention of Ram Mandir or Kartarpur Sahib during the poll rally does not constitute seeking votes in the name of religion. Instead, it asserted that it's a mere political attack. The poll panel says such comments don't violate moral code of conduct since Prime Minister Modi is listing the achievements of his government. Prime Minister Modi has often mentioned Ram Mandir and Kartarpur Sahib in his rallies to attack the opposition, especially the Congress party.
ने उन्हें तारीख भी बताई, समय भी बताया, निमंत्रण भी भेजा, लेकिन कांग्रेस के सातवें आसमान के अहंकार ने, वो अपने आप को राम से भी बड़ा मानते हैं, प्रभु राम से भी बड़ा मानते हैं, और उन्होंने प्राण प्रतिष्ठा के कार्यक्रम का निमंत्रण ठुकरा दिया। हमारे ऐसे संतों का वो अपमान है कि नहीं है, माता शबरी का अपमान है कि नहीं है, और ये क्षेत्र तो माता शबरी का स्थान है, छत्तीसगढ़ तो प्रभु श्री राम का ननिहाल है। मैं आपसे पूछता हूं, क्या ये छत्तीसगढ़ का अपमान है कि नहीं है? ये छत्तीसगढ़ का अपमान है कि नहीं है? क्या ये माता शबरी का अपमान है कि नहीं है?
My colleague Kanu Sharda is joining us live for more on this. So the Election Commission there at least indicating that there seems to be no violation in the poll code with the Prime Minister's reference of Ram Mandir or Kartarpur Sahib in his speeches, Kanu.
Sources from the Election Commission. The Election Commission is not inclined to entertain the petition filed by a lawyer as a representation before them, saying that the achievements, highlighted by the Prime Minister in his poll speeches is a violation of the Representation of People Act, and that Prime Minister should be barred from contesting election for next 6 years. But very interestingly, the Delhi High Court has also entertained this similar kind of plea by the same lawyer. And then he was asked to, approach the Election Commission. Now the Election Commission sources have indicated that they're not going to entertain this and going to tell the counsel in the case that, it's not a valid argument which he has put forth. And we are being told from the High Court sources that the High Court is scheduled to hear this matter in the coming week. So it will be a closure of the sorts, because if the Election Commission is saying that that no action can be taken under the Representations of People Act in this case, then there'll be no other authority which can, initiate an action so far, because the Election Commission is also a constitutional authority, and Delhi High Court will have to abide by what the Election Commission of India says in this, because it is the Election Commission of India which is the statutory body in the case, which decides whether the person concerned has done any violation or disqualified on any things. So High Court will have to adhere to what Election Commission of India conveys to it on as far as this petition is concerned.
Right, Kanu, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. My colleague there tracking those developments.